General navigation. To operate and monitor a building automation system, we have the work area, and we can navigate through our building or plant structure to the element we want to operate or monitor. This is possible by just clicking on the element from the list or by using the breadcrumb navigation bar to navigate back. To jump back to main entry point, use the root icon. With the help of the sub-navigation bar, we can operate and monitor our plants in different ways. Starting from the operation from the main bar, the first sub-navigation option is the plant view. By selecting the plant view, we can navigate through our building or to our plants and have a look to the graphical display of this specific plant. The next element, the scheduler, shows, again related to the selected object from our structure, the scheduler program for this specific plant. In the list view, we see a generic view of our building automation system, again related to the selected object. We can navigate through the system until a specific data point, and we can operate and monitor this data point. Please note that, if there are any data point missing from a plant in the list view, they will be not integrated during engineering. Nevertheless, it is possible to operate all data points in a generic way via the object view from the main bar. With this small icon in front of the element, we open the so-called magic bubble. This contains specific information about the data point or element. The menu trends shows the trend graphics related to this plant. The menu reports shows reports to be selected. Jumping back to the main bar, the next menu is events. In case of existing active events, a counter will be showed here to immediately inform the user. From here, we can monitor all the events related to the selected element. And we can acknowledge them and reset. Or we can even show the history of the event. On the left side, we have the menu tools and settings. The content of the menu tools depends on the selected sub-navigation bar menu. It is only available with appropriate user rights. Under the menu settings, we can define some specific project settings. Also, it is available only with appropriate user rights. On the top right side, we find the user management view that shows which user is currently logged in within the Desigo control point device. Here it is also possible to manage the user settings and log out from the session. In the main bar, we find the configuration menu. This offers some specific sub-navigation menu, like the device, showing some specific information of the used device, the network, where it is possible to adapt the network settings, the users, from where an account with administrator rights can add, edit, or delete users, and the assigned devices menu, from where it is possible to discover the network and assign devices to the Desigo control point. The last menu available in the main bar is the object view. This offers a generic view of all data points from all assigned devices, even if they are not integrated yet. To navigate back, just click on operation from the main bar.